Hi, this is Varun Mitra and this is Sandeep. Hi, Sandeep.
Hi, Varun. Well, I just have something to say about the spontaneous person who's sitting right next to me. You know, when he's got these, I mean, right now he looks very prim and proper with his haircut and everything. But then the best, he looks best with his, you know, a little bit of topsy-turvy hair and his puppy face and everything for that matter. So, of course, and I'm actually talking about someone who's genuinely, you know, handsome in a cute way. Hi, Varun. It's really great to have you.
Thank you for the introduction. Thank you.
My very first question to you is, since your Andheri days, since the time you came out of Bombay, your Andheri days and you...
I'm still in Andheri only.
Yeah.
We're still in Andheri days.
Okay. You know, going to the gym, hitting the gym in the evening and all of that. And till this, to this very day and the way you, I mean, wherever you are right now and whatever you have achieved, how has life treated you?
So it's been 6 years since I've been in Bombay now. And I think I've been quite lucky with everything. I think it's, I don't want to glorify it and call it a struggle. I would call it a journey. Mm-hmm. And I have been quite lucky since my first 2-3 months over here. I was lucky to get some big ads.
Yeah.
I lucky to work with some big directors. I got some travel shows early on in my career. So I've been quite busy, and every 3-4 months, something or the other good kept happening, which kind of kept my spirits up. And I was also lucky enough to get a few movie offers, which I did not think were the right ones to kind of get out there with, because our industry is very unforgiving and so is our audience.
Mm-hmm.
So actually the ads that happened and the travel shows, they kept me sane and they kept me from pulling all my hair out, which I would need while shooting Jalebi. But when this happened, I think my agent Shitij, who's with Kwan, he introduced me to Mukesh ji one day.
Okay.
And Mukesh ji met me, and he was a little intimidating in the beginning. And he just sat across the table, and there was a lot of silence in the room, you know. And whatever meetings I'd had so far, whichever ones had gone well, I'm used to some conversation and interaction happening. But with him, it was very serious, and I pulled out my iPad to show him my work. And I saw my Kindle ad, and he saw one festival.
The Amazon Kindle ad.
Yes. So Amazon has been very kind to me. Then I showed him one festival film that I've done, the teaser of that. And then he took me to Bhatt Saab's room. And before I knew it, I was offered Jalebi, and it was just like that.
Mm-hmm. So, you know, as far as your work is concerned, it has actually made you travel a lot. I mean, across countries, across continents for that matter. So how has that experience been? I'm sure, it kind of makes people like me really envious.
It makes a lot of people envious, and I love it. No, I've been really lucky, man. I think travel shows are everybody's dream job. Whoever
Absolutely.
I tell that I'm doing a travel show or I'm hosting a travel show, they're all like, they have the same reaction that you have. So I feel really grateful that I have, hosted.
And not any chota mota travel. He's talking about NHB Good Times.
Yeah.
It's a big chunk.
I've been lucky to be associated with all these channels. And the thing with travel shows is that it's so much fun, because it's not scripted.
Mm-hmm.
It's not planned. There is like, we know where we are going. We know mota mati what we're going to do. But what is going to happen in between, we don't know. Like, we could randomly stop at a... stall and have noodles over there, or like stop any, like it's just completely unplanned what happens over there. And I've gotten to meet some amazing people. My teams that I've worked with have been
talking about amazing people. You know, you've done this Amazon Kindle ad.
Yes.
And you kind of interact with like little kids in Korea.
Yes.
You have been to Dubai.
Sri Lanka.
Yeah. In Korea it was?
It was a travel show.
Okay.
Yeah.
And in Dubai, did Dubai really treat you as a king? I mean, you being a very simple and a sweet guy. I mean, remember I remember watching you in the ad where you said that, you know, I'm a very simple and sweet guy, something of that sort.
Yeah. But who doesn't like being treated as a king? Yeah,
that's what I'm asking.
No, Dubai knows how to pamper you. And I think you, when you get used to it and you come back to reality, it's a bit like, why have I come back here?
Okay.
Like that kind of situation, because suddenly like, from being treated like luxury, you come back to
Normalcy again,
yeah.
Talking about Jalebi, according to you, what was that, I wouldn't say motivating, but then what drove you to do your bits in the film?
What drove me to do
in my bits? A psychological way? Because from the promos, what I understand, it's a pretty, warped character. It has its own, mindset, a psychological bent towards...
What promo have you seen?
Jalebi. Yeah. When you're in love with a girl and somehow circumstances don't really fall, are in the way you want them to. And in the course of time, as and when life passes...
I'll tell you what the character...
You get introduced to another girl, you get married to her.
I'll tell you. Yeah. So... He's I wouldn't call him a warped character.
Mm-hmm.
I think he's...
Layered character.
He's the most simple character that I've ever come across.
Oh.
He's a really content sort of guy who's happy with his life, who gets happy with small things, and he's very attached to where he comes from. He's very attached to Purani Delhi and Purani Delhi ki gali and Purani Delhi ka food.
Yeah.
Which is actually why he's really attached to food, which is why he actually calls her Jalebi, because he relates everything and everyone to food. So because he thinks she's really sweet, he calls her Jalebi.
But Jalebi to a certain extent has another connotation as well. I mean, it's Jalebi matlab.
Jalebi us baat ka saboot hai ke uljhne bhi meethi ho sakti hai.
Okay.
So basically to say that, like relationships, like love, Jalebi also, like relationships, like it's as complicated, it's as round, and it's as, Jalebi also has to...
A jigsaw puzzle.
Yeah. Jalebi also has to go through burning oil
God,
become a Jalebi.
That's so,
relationships also have to go through a hell of a lot. You have to go through many heartbreaks and all. It has a double meaning in that sense, but the literal meaning of it is because I call her that in the film.
You call Rhea Jalebi.
Yes.
In the film. Okay. When you were, this is not your first film. You have been a part of another film, per se. So what exactly, according to you, if, for instance, if you're doing a character which is so deep and layered, how difficult is it to get yourself into the very mindset of the character and then come out of it the moment you say, the director says that?
The first thing I did was I took a journey on a train, because a lot of the movies shot on a train.
And then you went and, Delhi ki gali galiyaron mein aap jaake.
Yeah, and I have already spent time in
those
galis.
This is like so repetitive. Yeah? I mean, he said this same thing in so many NAV interviews.
Where?
Supposed to be different.
You want me to be different? Okay,
yeah.
Wait, how do I be different? But that's the fact.
It's a common,
It's a
fact.
The
question definitely is different. I asked you about the psychological upheaval that a character goes through. Whoever is portraying the role goes through, and then the moment you say cut.
I ask you to play a character, if you don't know where he comes from, how will you portray him?
That is definitely, that's like something which...
Sandeep on the spot!
No, not at all. That's something.
So I'll tell you. I'll answer your question.
You prepare for...
I'll answer your question fully. So I have spent time in Purani Delhi myself before this character and this sort of life came to me.
Yeah.
Because I used to work for an export house for 6 years.
Mm-hmm.
I was working for an export house and I...
You wanted to do something on your own as well?
No. I was not. I was working for somebody, and we used to make bags for a living. Like, we used to make bags, watches, jewelry, like all that kind of stuff. So we used to take our designers to Purani Delhi, to Chandni Talk, to Kinari Bazaar. So I have ended up in that scheme of things. I ended up spending a lot of time in Purani Delhi, eating the food over there and going to the shops and roaming around Kinari Bazaar with these people. So I was a little bit like familiar with that space.
Mm-hmm.
And then of course when this script came along and the character came along, I actually found some tour guides over there, and I went and then saw Purani Delhi, and I went on these tours with them. Some were 6 hours, some were 8 hours, different kind of tours, which made me see Purani Delhi in a completely different light. Because it's a different thing when you and me go there as a visitor, but it's a different thing when you see the place through someone's eyes who's actually lived there.
Yeah.
You know, so I got to go on people's chhats and they were doing kabutar bazi over there. Uh-huh. And then there was like chash in these corner places where I had not tried before. There was even jalebi, which we got to have and all. So it, I kind of experienced it differently. And as far as the psychological setting, if it is created, concerned, of course, whatever workshops and all that we do, that is a regular part of it. But Bhatt Sahab really helped with that. Mm. Bhatt Sahab really helped me get into the skin of the character, and I think we workshopped also so much that we kind of started living and breathing the character like on a daily basis, you know. So the more you kind of live with the script, the more number of times you read it, the more you think about the character, the more you write about the character, I think. Yeah. That kind of you start breathing the character after a point of time, and then you start thinking that, okay, what if they would do this, you know, how he would react would be like this, or you know, then you can see the distinction between how Varun would react and how Dev would react. So I think all of it combined with Bhatt Sahab's magical energy sort of helped me get into the psychological sort of, and of course the music. We really use the music to
my question, I don't really think that you comprehended.
Okay,
question.
Ask me again.
It was like when Varun reads a script and he kind of gets into the mindset of the character, and if the character is really layered, it's really, it actually has a lot of psychological upheavals that the character goes through in the script. As an actor, when you transform yourself into that character on screen, when you live that character on screen, how difficult is it for you to come out of it the moment, I mean, or do you very easily come out of it at the moment when the director says cut?
No, you don't come out of it.
Yeah, so how difficult is it for you? How easy is it for you?
So, I think if I wanted to come out of it, I would be able to come out of it.
Okay.
But the thing is, at least while the shoot is on, you don't want to come out of it. Because you want to feel everything the character is feeling, and you want to continuously feel it. At least that's how I enjoy it. So, like, sometimes it's very difficult because, you know, you take yourself into, like, especially when we were doing the harder scenes, the intense scenes, which are the sad scenes, like the scene where she leaves the house and she goes away. Like, you kind of make yourself relive the heartbreaks that you've had, right? Mm-hmm. And sometimes, you know, I used to take out my phone, go through pictures of my old relationships and whatever times that we've spent together and all. Then, I don't think as the character I get stuck. I get stuck as Varun then, in that space, after the cut is also called. Because at the end of the day, what you're seeing, yes, you're seeing the character, but I am trying to relive my heartbreaks. So then that becomes Varun not being able to let go after cut.
Okay, well said. Varun, my next question to you is, again, it meanders towards the music of the film. I personally love the film. I mean, love the music of the film. Which song is your favorite song from the film?
I think mine has been, from the beginning, has been Pal.
Okay.
And like the first time Mukeshji made us hear the whole album, he made us hear it together almost. And when I stepped out in the evening, I caught myself humming Pal ka tune. And also it's my first lip sync song that I've ever done. So it's always going to have a very fond memory for me.
Pal definitely is a wonderful song, but then I'm done listening to Arijit Singh all the time. So
why he's so good?
He's good. I mean, there's no denying it. But I mean, after a long
time. Sir, you're God.
After a long time, after a long time, KK has come back to the singing space, and I just love Pehle Ke Jaisa, especially because the song has so many layers to it. It kind of firstly, the way it's written. It's really part blank verse.
The lyrics are
yeah.
what are actually...
Exactly, the lyrics...
They like just straight go to your heart.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's in part blank verse. You don't really have every line with a similar kind of...
Yeah.
A word which kind of resembles the next. I mean, the word with which the line ends. And besides that, yes, I mean, the music itself is so soft and fluid.
Yeah.
That it really instantly hits your heart. I mean, I have listened to every song in the film, but that's the song that really, stood out.
I think it's also the most emotional song in the film because
all of a sudden became the most emotional song for him.
No. Not for me. I'm saying it's the most emotional song of the film.
Okay, of the film.
Of the film. Because the point at which it comes during the script is the most emotional point. Now, I can't tell you what it is.
Okay.
Because I'll give away and it'll become spoilers. But it's the most emotional point of the film that the song comes at. And I think once you see it, you'll understand that the visuals also kind of do full justice to the... And I feel like with songs, yeah, you hear them and you like them. But yeah. I think once you watch the movie and you understand the emotion with which it's written, it adds like more flavor to it then, you know what I mean? You kind of start liking it more.
So, my next question to you is, Mahesh Bhatt has definitely been, the maker of really some very, huge, beautiful, wonderful cinema. Working with him is definitely a dream come true for anyone who's just starting up in the industry.
Yeah.
He's definitely not directed the film. But I feel that there must have been some input as far as your character is concerned. So how was it? Was there any?
So he's been with us through quite a lot of the film.
Okay.
But yes, the director was Pushpati Bhardwaj.
Mm-hmm.
So the thing with what Bhatt Saab has basically given his breath to this film, if I was to put it like that. What has happened is that... So what used to happen is that on the set... Like, see, the thing with Bhatt Saab is that you're looking at me right now. You're looking at my face. You're looking at my nose and eyes. Yeah, he looks at all that also. But he's able to really see what's going on in your mind.
Okay.
Like, he works more on silences than on words. Like, you and me work on words more. So he'll see what's going on in your heart. He'll see what's going on in your mind. And then what he does is, just before the scene was to start, he'll just come and whisper something into your ear.
Okay.
Which completely changes the DNA of the scene.
Okay.
You know, in the way you're looking at the scene, the perspective with which you're looking at it is completely like, it just like, because as actors, what happens
is... one word or a statement of word?
No, it's something to do with your personal self. Like, I remember before one of the scenes, and I don't know if it'll make sense to you right now, because you don't understand the whole context of it to really get it. But he came to me and he's like, before one scene, and he's like, you know, as Varun, your biggest problem is that you're scared of showing love to people.
Okay.
Like, you know, now when you hear something like that about yourself, you already know it's there, but he just kind of puts it on the surface. And he says that, you know, I want you to go in and I want you to do this as a schoolboy. You know, like, I want you to do it as how a schoolboy would show love to this person right now. So that kind of just, as an actor, you need that much to kind of, play with for it to just kind of change perspectives. Because how I would address love today as Varun Mitra, as this age, would be very different as how I would do it without any guards, being a kid who is showing love to somebody else. So that just kind of, it's those little things which he says which just change it, I guess.
As in the way you portray the guy.
The way you portray the scene, because I think as actors what happens is that we all get stuck in the words.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we have a tendency to get stuck in the emotions and the words. Whereas I think from what I've learned with him, it's not really about the emotions and the words, it's really about the silences. So, yeah.
Besides that, when we're talking about cinema, especially the mainstream cinema, nowadays the trend has been that, you know, people are not really, especially the audiences, the paying public, they're not really drawn towards film which are content driven. At times they are, but most of the
not drawn.
Yeah, not drawn. Because, if it's a content driven film, you put in some Sheila Ki Jawani type thumka in the film, to shayad chal jaye. That, you know, it doesn't really happen. Why do you think it doesn't happen?
I don't completely agree with you. I think what is slowly happening is that...
people are actually going for content-driven films.
Yeah, people are going towards content-driven films, and that is why content-driven films are being made. Yes, there are still those films which have the Sheila Ki Jamani, which is... But we're in India, where a commercial Bollywood film with song and dance is always going to work.
Absolutely,
here.
Yeah.
And I hope it carries on working as well.
Mm-hmm.
Because there is... we have a huge population and there is a market for... every kind of cinema. But yes, even the masses now are opening up to concept-driven films, realistic films which have some truth in them, even if they're smaller films and That's I think it's because of that. It's a great time for us to, as actors, to kind of be in this industry and space and at this time. So yeah, don't agree with you.
Okay, fair enough. We all can agree, disagree. Well, the thing is, you know, at times what happens is, even though the film, I mean, there are some films, I don't really want to take the name, even though some films are really good as far as the content is concerned, you don't really have much, I mean, what do you call that, renowned faces. And what happens is, it renowned doesn't, faces, renowned
faces. Renowned faces.
So, I mean, they don't really garner much audience. So, that is the issue that I'm talking about. Even though, you know, the content of the film is just marvelous. I mean, you watch them, like for instance, Love, Sonia. I love the film. You watch the film, it's just beautiful. It's hard-hitting, it's stark. People didn't really go to watch the movie. Why do you think is that the case?
Well, I haven't seen Love, Sonia myself.
I'm just saying.
So I don't know why people didn't go watch the film.
I'm just saying, Baba.
But, like, I don't... Like, I think each film comes with its own destiny.
Yeah.
Sometimes a film with like a Vicky Donor, which came with absolutely newcomers, new director, I think, at the time, and not a very big producer backing it like that. It did so well.
Yes, it did.
It did so well. And I think some of the bigger films that have come out with the biggest cast and biggest like marketing and promotion and activities which have happened have not worked. So I don't think it's about scale anymore. I don't think it's about, I mean, of course it is about content, but I don't think it's about anything else except the fact that it comes with the destiny of working. And if it sort of has a certain connection with the audience, then it works. So there's no, I mean, I don't think anybody can explain the phenomena that is our industry, because that Friday is always going to be a question mark. What you can do and what we can do, and I was just telling somebody else this today also, was that main jitna kar sakta tha maine kar liya, aur yahan ki puri team ne matlab sara apna khoon paseena, everything they've kind of put into it. Now rest what it happens is up to him, man. Then we see. Guys, Jalebi is out on the 12th of October. The soul of our film is relationships, and if you have ever had a broken heart, or yeah, if you've ever had a broken heart, I think you should go watch it, because I think while feeling for our characters, you will feel for yourself. So watch it on the 12th of October.